Hello friend, a lot of my students often keep asking me that sir, I am contemplating a decision whether to pursue the 1 year MBA from ISB, be it from the Hyderabad or Mohali campus, which is automatically given to you. So every year around 900 odd students, you know, 886, 870, 880 is the average thing, join the two campuses of ISB. So then is this decision worth it? What are the learning outcomes that I will have? Is it worth the cost? Because this year, let's say the cost is 36,07,000 rupees for a studio apartment plus 1.95 lakhs for laptop, books, meal plan. So it is around 38 lakhs. And if your average work ex is nearly 5 years, so 4.6 years, which is the average for the batch, ranging from a minimum of 2 years to a max of 12 years, so your salary also should be around 15 to 20 lakhs. So in that case, it becomes a big decision in terms of the cost. So friends, that's how it is. Plus, if you look at, you know, the ISB versus IIM debate, which never dies, because people will always want to compare India's top-notch ABCL with ISB. So it's specific questions that, okay, if I want to get into investment banking, because that's the normal desire of a student nowadays, in that case, how does ISB Hyderabad fare? And let's say if I'm a chartered accountant, do I really add value to my profile with the help of an ISB degree? So there are a lot of debates in the market around this. But let's look at, you know, what is the overall profile. So ISB Hyderabad, one advantage is that you take GMAT and not CAT. So instead of having an onerous task such as having a consistent score around 10, 12 and your graduation in the 90s plus a 99.5 plus kind of a percentile in CAT for ABC, here it's based on GMAT. And the best part about here is that in GMAT also, they are not very fixated about the particular score that they're looking at. Although the average score on GMAT is 709 out of 800, it varies from a minimum of 600 to a maximum of 770. So even if your GMAT score is a low of 600, which is a very bad score that way, in case you are able to compensate it by demonstrating your leadership capabilities in the interview, because ISB places a lot of emphasis on your letters of reference, your statement of purpose, whether you've articulated leadership capabilities in your career hitherto. So in that case, you get a better chance to get into ISB Hyderabad. So in terms of admission, so let's say if you've not been able to get into the IIM ABCL kind of a thing or FMS, and you still want that top-notch MBA, then maybe ISB is one choice. Also, if you want a more diverse batch, because, you know, if you have got 900 people in the batch, it is far more enriching in terms of the overall cohort. Plus, there are no reservations in ISB. So that's one advantage for some people who think that, you know, half of the batch will be scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, OBC, which is not worth it. So in that case, there's an advantage here. You've got more experienced people in the batch. You will never ever get in the IIMs people like with 12 years of work is in the 2 year. So ISB typically has got some features of the 1 year MBA at IIMs and some features of the 2 year MBA at IIMs. So overall it is young in terms of the batch profile, 4.3 years. So towards the 2 year thing, but yes, in terms of the overall thing, it has got some attributes of the 1 year also. You also lose your salary only for 1 year if you join ISB. So let's take a look at what is the kind of placement that they have. Now, one catch here is that ISB will always report the mid 80 percentile. So it eliminates the bottom 10 and the top 10. And 80 percentile of the offers, not the acceptances. So what happens typically here is that last year, 375 companies came to ISB. They made around 1100 plus kind of offers. So let's say in that guy who's got 10 years of work ex, he's got 3 offers, 40, 38 and 36 lakhs per annum. He chooses 40 lakhs. So 36 and 38 lakhs offers don't go to someone else. But then when the institute computes the average of the offer, it computes it on the basis of offers made. So 38, 36 and 40, all these three numbers get into that computation of the average. So ISB Hyderabad's offer average for mid 80 percentile has been 22.14 lakhs for the current batch. So that is one gray area. The other thing is that even though it's a new school, relatively 2001 vintage as compared to IIMs, which are more than 40 years, top-notch companies come here. So 20% of the batch will get placed in top-notch consulting firms, McKinsey, BCG, Bain, Deloitte, Strategy and Operations, AT Kearney, KPMG, PwC. There's no dearth of consulting jobs on campus. Plus, a lot of companies come here with leadership programs. You know, typically Aditya Birla Group, Yes Bank, Philips, Tech Mahindra, all of these are going to come on ISB for a special leadership program, which, for example, Aditya Birla Group for experienced candidates will has a lead and leap program. So it gives a lead and a leap program to the experienced guy, which is someone equivalent to a TAS. So Tata Administrative Services does not go to ISB Hyderabad, but Aditya Birla Group's leadership program, lead and leap, does go. And similarly, Axis Bank recruits only women. It hires women for a special rotational leadership role. Along with consulting, the hot thing on campus is IT and IT-enabled services. So you've got the likes of Apple, Google, Amazon, which recruit on campus. You've got a good number of startups coming here like Flipkart, and let's say this year you've got Oyo Room, Shopclues, Droom, etc. So that way, they have managed to get a good placement. If you look at their official release, what they say is that once you graduate from ISB Hyderabad, your average increase in salary is 160% after 3 years. So that's a phenomenal salary. So once you join, so it's not just the average exit salary of 22.14 that one needs to consider. After 3 years, this 22.14 subsequently increases by 160%. That's what they claim. There's nothing verified that sure. So that is one thing that you need to see. They kind of admit you in different segments, like an early entry option, which is there for freshers, that you gain an admission, then take a deferment. Now deferment comes at a cost of 2.5 lakh rupees, non-refundable security deposit. So you take an admit offer and say, okay, I'll go and get some work X, and then I'll come back and complete my 1 year MBA. So in that case, these guys are going to take a 2.5 lakh rupees non-refundable thing. Then you've got this young leadership program, and then the experienced guys, which is there. So if you look at the placements, kind of decent, but yes, there are controversies regarding why they report only 80 percentile, why they report the average offer and not the average of acceptance, which is done by the other IIMs. In terms of admission, you've got an advantage because the perceived difficulty of GMAT is far less as compared to CAT. And you've got far more reasons to prove yourself, especially, you know, for people with work experience. Once you are 4-5 years into work experience, then it's very difficult to prove yourself on the CAT turf by getting 99.5 plus kind of percentiles to get an admission into ABCL kind of a thing. So here you've got people who are willing to listen to the quality of your work experience once you've cleared the basic hurdle of GMAT. So that's in terms of admissions, it is better. In terms of, or better, one would not want to say, because, you know, different people will have different views on that, that it's far more easier to get into ISB, which I also have an opinion that since they have a huge batch size to fill, they are not very particular on the entry barrier. Okay, and you can again apply in the round 1 and then in round 2 and next year if you got reasons to prove that yes, I have improved myself. That's one thing. Plus, but one thing good about ISB is also that the faculty, a lot of international professors come here from various universities in the world. So that is one thing where they've clearly maintained an edge over others. Even in IIMs, I have not seen much of, you know, those European and American professors coming here to teach. But in ISB, that's a good thing because you got even professors from Kellogg and Wharton's coming down for one particular course. They teach and they go away because they pay people fantabulously well. You know, they are... this is their focus kind of a thing. And yes, also in terms of international placements, they get a good number of international placements like Cargill, Apple, Coty, which is a spin-off from Procter & Gamble. They have recruited people for the international thing. So last year, 30 people got international offers. So there were 30 international offers on a totality basis. So that's something which is very good. Okay. One catch about ISB is that it does not offer you either a diploma or a degree. It is not recognized by ICTE, which is the standard All India Council for Technical Education. What it says is that I will only give you an experience certificate that you have been part of the ISB program for 1 year. It is neither a degree nor a diploma. For some people who want to pursue higher education, this becomes a bottleneck that they are not offering a degree or a thing, but yes, they've got some accreditation, AQS accreditation and some other management associations. So that's one thing. Investment banks don't come to ISB, mostly they don't come. Yeah, off campus you can try, and once you got the MBA tag, people are willing to take you, let's say, in an M&A of a Tata Steel, and then you can, let's say, later move into an investment banking role. So that's for sure. But yes, on campus you will not have much of investment banking coming. Investment banks will come to India primarily on IIM Ahmedabad and Calcutta campus, more on Calcutta campus, few people on B campus. So, but an overall ABC included, you've got only 10 to 12 investment banking offers. Why I'm harping on investment banking? Because I receive a lot of queries about people who want to get into investment banking, primarily lured by the 1 crore kind of a salary which they have. So because they've got some 45 lakhs of a fixed base plus 100% variable. If the all things go well and they've got a good number of deals which they strike during the year. So that way is yes. And in terms of the cost, there is one savior here, that State Bank of India is willing to give you a loan of up to 40 lakh rupees for ISB. And out of that 40 lakhs, it is willing to give you 30 lakh rupees without any collateral. So it gives you at 8.35% floating for a 13-year tenor. And that starts once the course completes, once you start earning. So if you look at it, instead of looking at it at a 38 lakh kind of a thing, you should look at it in more of a deferred cost, where you pay a branding cost for 13 years, for 35 to 40,000 per month kind of an EMI. Yes, but if you are also struggling along with this, also with a home EMI, this might become a difficult financial proposition for you. That having been said, MB always rewards people in the long run. Even if you compare the IIM Ahmedabad PGPX or IIM Bangalore EPGP or IIM Calcutta PGPX, okay, or the international ones, the initial, you cannot really judge the efficacy of an MBA program just by the exit salary or what is the kind of role you get there, because there's far more that can happen to you post MBA in that entire career. So I have seen chartered accountant friends of mine, so who post ISB joined ENY in transaction advisory and did a lot of traveling, and finally one day they were able to move to private equity, because you know, you build connections with private equity once you are there, and then now they are having their own startups in stealth mode, or even full-fledged startups. If you look at a lot of startups, they've been promoted by ISB alumni. One good thing about ISB is that their alumni base is very, very strong and very, very active, because ISB alums really want the brand to be taken to the next level. So if you see on Quora also, all ISB alumni people, they speak very highly about ISB. That's one good thing. Yes, maybe, you know, they don't bring out the rough edges of the whole thing, but that's for a separate discussion. Overall, what I feel is that it's a good choice as far as if you want to stay in India, work in India, and you want to get that coveted MBA tag. Maybe it comes at a higher cost vis-a-vis the other IIMs or an FMS or a Jamnalal Bajaj, but that's fine. At least you have an MBA, you've got world-class education, international professors, a large batch size. This has its own advantages and disadvantages. Disadvantages means that even if you have got chartered accountants, there are 40-50 chartered accountants in the batch. You really don't have a competitive advantage. Okay, and you've got the best and best 65% engineers are there. But yes, this ratio is relatively less as compared to IIMs, because there it was going to border around 80% plus. So large batch size will have its advantage. You can also say that the company which comes on campus feels that yes, it's got 900 profiles on offer, which is a good thing for the company, because it's far more people are on offer in the market. So that's how it is. Don't just look at it on the short run term. But yeah, there are some caveats. One thing which I always tell people about the 1 year MBA is that please, because it's a very expensive proposition, more than 50 lakh rupees down the investment funnel, and you really need to study there, you know, as compared to IIM Ahmedabad's PGPX, where there's a great non-disclosure, placements and grades have no linkages. Here it's a rat race, everything depends on your grades. So every term you are fighting for grades. So you also need to be prepared for whether you will be able to give that academic input on campus. So those are things that you need to look. And yes, the difference between Hyderabad and Mohali really doesn't matter, because you really don't have any say also here. After the end of the admission process, you will be told that you've been allotted Hyderabad or Mohali. That's it. And they have been trying to keep it equal. And in fact, in the last semester's term 3 and 4, they have exchanged also between the two campuses. That's how it is. And on a B school, you've got all those opportunities of a lot of clubs, a lot of external speakers going for competitions on a national scale. So I was recently mentoring a girl, so she won a pan India business competition, business plan competition for revival of a particular company conducted by a leading media house, and wow, that becomes a big CV point, and maybe she'll get good placements also. So that's how it is. Thank you so much for watching. Look at it from what you really want from the course, and is the course willing to offer you, because you'll have a vast diaspora of judgments here. Don't go by that, kind of confuses you completely. Thank you so much for watching. If you've got any questions, please put it in the comment section below. I shall be more than glad to answer. All the best.